Today, I want to challenge your perspective about artificial intelligence. You may have already heard that AI is everywhere. When you scroll through content on social media, AI is deciding what you see. When you walk into some banks and ask for a loan, AI algorithms decide whether you deserve it or not. Some companies even use AI to decide who to hire. What you may haven't heard, though, is that you can play a part in this revolution. You see, even though AI is always taking more and more space in our lives, just an extremely limited amount of people understands it, let alone use it for their own gain. The majority of people either fears AI or passively ignores it. And if you are part of this last group, I want to change this. In 10 minutes from now, not only are you going to have a better understanding of AI, but you're going to realize that AI is one of the most powerful technologies we have available and is just a tool in the hands of humans. And since my assumption is that all of you here are humans, this means that it's a tool that you can use as well. If I succeed, I'm going to have inspired you to embrace one of the most powerful technologies we ever had available. So are you ready? I'm going to start with my personal experience with AI, how I decided to start working with AI. Because you see, I wasn't supposed to be here. I'm an energy engineer, so I was supposed to be designing solar panels or wind turbines, that kind of stuff. AI had nothing to do with it. But then one day, I received an email that changed my life. I had been selected to go study and work in Silicon Valley, absorb as much as I could from that magical place, and then come back to my country to use all that knowledge. And to give you an idea about what Silicon Valley represents for someone like me who's passionate about technology, it's a little bit like the Champions League for a football fan. All the best minds in the world have worked there, from Steve Jobs and Bill Gates back in the days to Elon Musk and Mark Zuckerberg today. All of them focused in a small place with less people than my hometown. So I remember when I arrived there, one of the first days I rented a car and I started driving from Silicon Valley up until San Francisco. And I saw a giant billboard on the highway. It said, name of a company, artificial intelligence and machine learning. And I thought, wait a minute. If I'm driving on the highway in Italy, I'm going to see advertising of pasta companies, maybe some fashion companies, but for sure, I'm not going to see anyone advertising AI on the highway. So what is going on here? Either these people are completely crazy, or I'm missing something. And so I needed to figure out which one of the two was the case, so I started doing some research. And one pivotal moment was when I met one of the pioneers of AI, Peter Norvig. He was talking about how computer scientists were trying to build software to automatically translate human languages. So this is what he told me. Let's suppose that you want to build some software that translates English to Italian. This is what you will have to do without AI. You will have to find a way to express in rules all the nuances of Italian and English grammar. And that's super hard. Computer scientists have been trying to do that for decades with very poor results. But then he told me how AI completely changes the game. This is what you will have to do with AI. You will take a bunch of books in English, a bunch of books in Italian, the direct translation of these books. You will give them to a computer and tell it, hey, I'm not going to explain you how to translate these two languages, but these are some examples. Go figure it out. This approach is called machine learning. And the beauty of it is that once computer scientists did all the hard work of giving computers the gift of learning, then all of us can use this technology to teach computers what we want. Do you want to teach computers how to drive a car? Cool. Get enough data of people driving, give it to a computer, and it's going to figure out how to do it. Do you want to teach a computer how to diagnose a disease? Awesome, just get enough x-rays of sick and healthy individuals, give them to a computer, and it's going to learn how to differentiate between the two. And this is the first reason that made me fall in love with AI. Its basic principles are pretty easy to understand for everybody, because this is how we learn. I don't know you, but my mom didn't teach me how to speak Italian by giving me a grammar book. and telling me, hey, Gianluca, go to your room, read it, and then come back once you've finished it. She just spoke to me. And my brain by itself was able to decode all these complex rules that make Italian grammar. But you may think, okay, Gianluca, cool. This sounds pretty easy. It's pretty simple, right? Why didn't we do it 20 years ago? It turns out that today, we are in the best moment in history to build AI. And this is because to build AI, we need two ingredients. The first one is data. So all the examples that we need to give the computer to learn, right? So since I started this pitch roughly 5 minutes ago, actually I have the timer there, more than 2,000 hours of video have been uploaded to YouTube. More than 200 million messages have been shared on WhatsApp, and more than 1.5 million stories on Instagram. This is an ocean of data, completely overwhelming for any human being, but a goldmine for computers that can learn from all this data and understand our world. But we need also a second ingredient, because you see, computers need to be powerful to learn from all this data. So let's see how we are doing today compared to 20 years ago. 20 years ago, the most powerful computer in the world was owned by the US government. They were using it to make simulations for the nuclear power plants. It costed $47 million. It occupied 150 square meters, so it's big as a big apartment, you know? And it had 1.3 teraflops of computing power. A teraflop is just a unit of measure of computing speed. It means trillion operations per second. Let's see how we're doing today. So what I brought here is a special kind of chip. This is called a graphical processing unit. And it's particularly efficient to train some kinds of AI models called neural networks. And you can buy today some of these models for $2,000. And this will give you roughly 130 teraflops, 100 times more than the most powerful computer that we had 20 years ago. Just let that sink for a minute. Right now, in my hand, I am holding 100 times the computing power that the US government had available 20 years ago for the price of a used motorbike. So this is the second reason that made me fall in love with AI. It's democratic. You don't need multi-billion dollar budgets to start building AI. All of you potentially could go back home tonight, open your laptops, and start building some powerful AI algorithms. And that's actually what I did. When I came back from Silicon Valley to Italy, I was dying to learn all this knowledge and apply it, so I went deep down into the rabbit hole of online courses, and I really wanted to apply all that knowledge. But there was one tiny little problem. I was unemployed. So, you know, there was no company that would give me a fun project to play with. But instead of waiting for someone to give me something to work on, I decided to come up with my own projects. So there was a company in the United States who had used AI to analyze the energy consumption data of millions of Americans and help them save energy. And they had been acquired for $500 million. So they were, you know, pretty successful. And remember, at the time, I wasn't an expert about AI, but I was an energy engineer, so I could really understand the context of that application, right? So here's what I did. I took some free energy data from the internet. I took one of the few AI algorithms that I knew, and I started to try to replicate the project. Then I wrote a blog post that I titled, I reverse engineered a $500 million AI company in 1 week. Here's the full story. Posted it on my blog and went to sleep. The next morning, I woke up, picked up my phone, and it was burning. Overnight, the article had gone viral in the United States. More than 100,000 people had read it, and my inbox was flooded with emails from people that wanted to meet me, wanted to thank me for the inspiration. Some wanted to give me jobs. I even found out that Jack Dorsey, the founder of Twitter, had read the article. One of the emails was from a guy called Alex. Alex was the head of data science at a Silicon Valley company. They were also trying to use AI to optimize energy consumption. And Alex offered me a job. And I started having quite a lot of imposter syndrome, you know, getting my first job in Silicon Valley. So I told Alex, I was like, hey, Alex, listen, I appreciate the offer, but I am not an expert in AI. His answer has been a defining moment for my career. Alex told me that he didn't care about how good I was in AI. What he valued was creativity and a burning passion to try to solve these problems that we both cared about. Alex told me that AI is just a tool waiting for people with good ideas to use it. Since that moment, my career, my work life, has been dedicated to trying to spread this message as much as possible. Just think about this. How many people in the world have great ideas, but don't know that they can use AI to turn these ideas into reality? AI is a tool. It's not different from, let's say, a hammer. If you take a hammer by itself, it's useless. But give it to a carpenter, and it can be used to build a beautiful house for your family. Give it to an artist, and it can be used to create an inspiring statue out of pure marble. All of you here, all of you care about something. It may be climate change, it may be social justice, animal welfare, whatever that is, AI can be a tool that you can use to turn your ideas and your dreams into reality. You see, a lot of people say AI is changing the world. I don't think that's what's happening. What is happening is that people who use AI are changing the world. It's people who are in the center of this. So if AI is just a tool, then the question becomes, what are you going to build with it? Thank you.